Welcome back to the 700 Club. Today is one of our favorite days, which is Skinny Slash Healthy Wednesday. Well, for many of us, comfort foods are fatty foods, but our next guest was actually going to show you. Doesn't have to be.
Getting healthy might mean changing the way you eat and cook, but that's not always easy when you have a family to feed. Catherine Cassidy and the Taste of Home editors came up with a six-week meal plan. They picked America's favorite recipes and made them healthier and lighter. In the Taste of Home comfort food diet, you can enjoy pizza, mac and cheese, and even cheesecake and still lose weight. No one will be deprived when you prepare the meals your family craves the most, and your diet won't feel like a diet at all.
Doesn't that food look good? Please welcome back to the 700 Club, the author of The Taste of Home Comfort Food Diet Cookbook, Catherine Cassidy. Cassidy, I tell you, your name is a tongue twister. Try to say that one three times fast.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming back with us. Okay, now when I think of comfort foods, I cannot lie. I think of like cheese and breads and sweets and things that instantly go to my hips and thighs. And you say, but the comfort foods don't necessarily have to be that way.
That's right.
Yeah.
When they are portioned properly, you can eat a lot of great foods like lasagna, like meatloaf, like cheese, things like that, and still lose weight. And the comfort food diet book is all about that.
Interesting. The one thing that you say in your book is that you keep all the meals about 1,400 calories a day. What's
That's
the significance
right.
with that value? And does it matter how big you are, small you are, man or female?
Well, that's an average. 1,400 calories is an average. And what we found is that at that level, people can be satisfied, you know, and they don't get hungry, so you're not binging on things, but you can still lose weight. It's not going to melt off, but it's going to come off gradually, and that's the way you want it to work.
And that's the whole thing. That is
exactly.
true. You want to be consistent.
Right.
Okay, so how have you made the comfort foods comforting but yet not fatty?
Well, a lot of it's portion control, just making sure that you're not eating something as big as your head. That's
not,
we don't want to do.
What are some of the concrete changes?
Well,
I guess that was my question.
Sure. Reduced fat products,
gotcha.
Things like egg substitute, fat-free milk, those types of things. Adding vegetables instead of meats, you know, so that you're just making things a little bit healthier and bringing the calorie count down.
Phenomenal. One of the things that you've done, which you've kind of modified something, and breakfast, for instance,
right.
tends to be the same for many of us. It's either oatmeal or maybe a shake or something of that sort. But
right.
you've done something different with a crepe. Let's talk about
well,
a breakfast.
These crepes are really fun. I actually think they're really fun to make with your kids.
Yeah.
And they're easy. I think people think of crepes as, oh, my gosh, that's going to be hard. And it's really not. This is the strawberry crepe roll-up that we're going to make.
Okay.
And this is for breakfast. Two of these crepes is just 137 calories, and I'm hoping that you'll try one.
Oh, girl, you don't have to
Because then
hope.
You'll know how great it is. So we're going to make one right now.
All right.
All right? So we're going to spray the pan.
Gotcha.
We have a batter here that's made with fat-free milk, egg substitute, a little bit of flour, sugar, just a tiny bit of sugar,
okay.
and a little salt and some vanilla.
All right.
So we're going to take about 2 tablespoons.
Now, as you're doing this, the thing I've always wondered when it comes to cooking is sometimes when you modify and you change an ingredient, it just doesn't come out the same. For instance, you said egg substitute rather than eggs, but will the product come out differently? Or
You know, actually, it depends on what you're making, but generally speaking, you can substitute pretty well without, you know, for something like this, we've used fat-free milk and we've used egg substitute, and it's really going to be exactly the same.
Okay.
It's not, I mean, you won't be able to taste a whole lot of difference.
Yeah.
So anyway, we put this in here, and I'm...
Do we need to turn it up?
I'm thinking that maybe we need to turn this up
okay.
a little bit so that it actually cooks.
Well, as that's cooking, because I love the art of TV,
sure.
we're going to pretend like... That's done.
Yes. And then we're going to make the crepe. Actually, you're going to make the crepe.
Okay.
So what you'll do is take a little bit of
Am I going to use this?
The fruit preserves.
All right.
And just spread a little bit on there, and that's going to give it some nice flavor.
Now, the kind that I saw the other day at the store was they had sugar-free preserves now, but then they also have real sugar rather than high fructose corn syrup?
Right.
Does that make a difference?
This is all fruit, and that's why we like it. It doesn't have any additional sugar in it.
Okay, do I need more?
No, you're actually perfect there.
Okay.
And a few strawberries, and you can put them on. Just be kind of generous with the strawberries.
Oh, I can be generous. I'm all about generosity.
Finally getting to set
okay.
up here. And then you just take that and roll it up.
I think I put too many strawberries to roll.
Well, just turn it over.
Okay.
Just turn it over.
It's over.
And then just sprinkle it with some powdered sugar.
Oh, I'm all about that. Look at that. Look at the beauty.
I am going to try to flip this crepe to prove that it actually can be
done. And so that's it. Is this the meal?
That is the meal.
Okay.
You get two of those for 137 calories. We also have, is this going to work now?
You're still working with that crepe, aren't you?
I'm still working with the crepe.
You're determined.
Yeah.
All right, well, as I take a bite of this, let's hit the lunch over there.
Okay. Let's just pretend this works.
Oh, that's yummy. We'll just pretend.
This is really easy to do when the burner is on right. Anyway, I'm going to turn this off
now. This is really good, though.
And we have that with some chicken apple sausage, which is just four ingredients. It's wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
For lunch, we've got a zucchini tomato soup, which is made with all kinds of wonderful vegetables.
Oh, yummy.
And some spicy V8 juice. And that's what gives it kind of a wonderful flavor.
Now, would you go low sodium V8 juice?
You could.
Because the sodium is so high in that?
Sure, you could absolutely do that. A ranch chicken salad that has a really wonderful creamy mayo.
Okay.
So you can see it is absolutely not diet food at all.
Yeah.
For snack, because we all like our snacks, we've got some spiced honey pretzels. And these are pretzels that have a little bit of cayenne pepper, some honey, and you just pop them in the oven.
You use
regular pretzels, but it kind of takes the pretzel to a new level.
And it's fun.
Yes, absolutely.
Now, what is that again?
The spiced honey pretzels.
With honey and cayenne.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Delish.
Delish. And then we have that with the diet soda, which is one of the free foods on the plan.
Mm-hmm.
For dinner, we have the Jamaican turkey wraps.
Oh, that sounds yummy.
It is very yummy with a sweet, kind of a sweet and sour dressing and a little bit of broccoli coleslaw that we put in there.
And I'm surprised about the potato salad.
You can actually have potato salad on this diet. Yes, the honey Dijon potato salad.
Okay.
Is that good?
It's
yummy.
Really good.
Excellent.
So how is that low fat?
Well, you're using some fat-free mayo.
Oh, good.
And some of it is portioned, too. I mean, you can't, you don't want to pile the plate full of it.
But
that's a nice serving.
Okay. That's a lovely serving. Going to eat that after the show.
Yes, you can. And then for dessert, we have to have dessert. So we have our yummy chocolate cake.
God bless America.
There you go.
Okay, so let's talk about how chocolate cake is fat-free or is good for you.
Well, it's all about the portion that you have.
Okay.
And if you have it in conjunction with, the rest of the day that is really, that's nice and low calorie, then you can absolutely have a dessert.
Can I just say this, Catherine? I was happy before the show. I was happy at the beginning of the show, but now I think I'm just thrilled.
You're really happy. That's good, and I'm glad that I could make you happy.
All right, well, if you want more information on the recipes you just saw today, and they're really yummy, can I just tell you? All you have to do is just check out the Taste of Home Comfort Food Diet Cookbook, which is available nationwide. And for more of Catherine Cassidy, this is really funny. We have some behind-the-scenes exclusive footage that we shot this morning that I didn't know about, so I'm kind of scared. Well, all you have to do is just log on to CBN.com and kind of see the behind-the-scenes in the green room footage, and that's going to be really fun. Catherine, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
And I have to admit, I feel comforted with that comfort food.
Good.
Yeah.
And that's how you should feel.
And thin. All right, Pat, over to you.